So today we have a new music video. I finally get to share this music video that I shot for the lovely Ori Rose, who's a dear friend of mine. We're actually on the in crowd because this song doesn't come out until July 14th, so 2 days from now. So welcome to the world of exclusivity, because you're getting a little sneak peek here. That being said, make sure you pre-save the song on Spotify. Check out Ori on Instagram. Do whatever you can to support Ori for me. So the plan here is to first watch the music video in its entirety. Then afterwards, I want to discuss the gear I used to create this, and then follow that by discussing about what I would have done differently if I could have changed anything in the video. So without any further ado, go ahead and enjoy the music video.
Get lost in this nonsense again and again. She hangs on way too tight, like it's her dear life. And I should probably run away. Said fuck my friend's advice, just come through tonight. I'll ruin my life with you, baby. But Casey, I don't wanna buy you drugs, like you so much better. Took away all of my youth now. I'm 20 going on 42 now. I hesitate and then get chewed out. No point in conversations, I can't seem to shake this. Cause she hangs on way too tight, like it's her dear life. And I should probably run away. Said fuck my friend's advice, just come through tonight. I'll ruin my life with you, baby. But Casey, I don't wanna buy you drugs, like you so much better.
Just a fun little music video that I had a ton of fun shooting. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope Ori enjoyed it. He said he did, but I hope he deep down enjoyed it, because obviously that's the end goal. So changing gears a little bit, going into talking about gear. Get it? We're changing gears to talk about gear. But before we even talk about gear, I want to first thank today's video sponsor, who is Milnote, for both supporting this project financially and also supporting this project by giving us the tools to effectively plan and organize the pre-production of this music video, certainly amongst a chaotic, crazy schedule. Not only on this music video in particular, but I use Milnote to organize my pre-production, whether it's mood board, reference images, scene breakdown, storyboard, logistics, whatever you can think of. Total lifesaver, a filmmaking tool, honestly, especially for one-man band filmmakers like myself. So before you plan your next shoot, go ahead and check out MillNote in the description down below. Changing gears again, back to our gear discussion. I shot this music video on my Sony FX3, which I'm using to film this with. Also shot it on a couple of lenses, my Sony 24-70 f/2.8. Then I also mixed it with this Sony 20mm f/1.8. And also got a couple shots on the 14mm f/1.8. Sony actually sent that over for me to try out, which I love. No diffusion filters used on the front of my lens. I did have a UV filter on the front that's a little dinged up, so maybe that added a little character, but yeah, no like black prime mist or anything. And then I graded the entire video using my new S-Log 3S Cine Gamut 3 or whatever, PP8 profile. I used my new music video LUTs that I created to color grade this entire thing. Yeah, overall, I thought the FX3 held up very lovely. It was my first ever music video that I've created in full using the FX3. And I was a little worried about looking too clinical, looking a little too clean, but I was able to grade it into that film look that I like to put on music videos very easily. And a small portable was able to rip more shots than I would have, put it on and off the gimbal with no problems at all. So still loving the FX3, held up wonderfully throughout the production of a music video. Moving on, trying to do my moonwalk with my fingers as I transition. But moving on to things I would have done differently. First off, I love this video. You know, with the schedule that we had going on, the amount of budget that we had, I thought it turned out very lovely. I'm a fan of it. I think it's fun. I think it fits the song super well. I was able to try out new things I'd never tried. I ripped the drag shutter in those black and white scenes inside my living room, just lighting everything with a flashlight, pointing directly at Ori and our talent, Casey. The main thing I would have changed was not shooting 7 videos within this week that we were shooting these music videos. Kind of got a little over my head, and I think I should have focused on like 2 music videos, because that leads into the next thing I would have changed. Because towards the back half of the song, as you maybe noticed, that I was kind of just running dry on clips. I didn't have a ton of stuff in that like blue hour, like darker type vibe that you were getting that matched that performance scene of Ori against that purple sky with the light shining on him. I felt like the first half of the song had a ton of different clips that I was able to cut between that made for a really fun edit. And towards the back end of the song, I was kind of, you know, grabbing that thin air to make anything, you know, kind of pop off a little bit without hanging on to that one performance take for too long, which I ended up doing. Another thing I wish I did differently was when Ori was doing those performance scenes on the beach, when the sun was still up, before he was all shredded up and dirtied. I wish I shot those a little bit later in the day, where the sun was just dropping a little bit more, maybe 45 minutes later. It was around like 5 p.m. that we were shooting those, and I kind of wish I shot those closer to 6 p.m. I was kind of worried about how much time we would have. We ended up having more time than we needed, so I kind of wish I waited a little bit longer to shoot those, because I felt like I was bouncing those bright sun highlights the entire time, and it was kind of overwhelming the frame. The last main thing that I would have changed, I wish I implemented a little bit more of a narrative. Obviously, we went into this kind of just thinking it would be a performance-based video, not story-driven at all. But especially after getting those scenes of the Casey character yelling at Ori in the car, I kind of wish we played out a little more of a storyline amongst that. But again, obviously the plan was to just make it a flashy performance video, not necessarily story driven. So I don't know. It's cool. It's a music video. Yeah, don't forget to say what's up to Ori. I'll link his stuff in the description down below. Definitely send him my praises and help support him for me. Pumped to share more of those music videos from that week that we shot them with you all. So looking forward to that. And thanks as always for watching. I love you.